What advice do you have for any aspiring writer, YouTuber, creator who wants to kind of, you know, be the next you?
Be the next me? I would say aim higher. No. This is terrible advice that I'm going to say right now. And the only reason why I say it's terrible is because when you hear this, if you're an aspiring writer, creator, YouTube person, because I get this question a lot, it's going to sound terrible to you and you're going to curse at me. And the only reason I know that you're going to do this is because I used to do it. And you don't realize until you start making the things that this is exactly right. My biggest piece of advice is just do it. And I know everyone out there is yelling at me. If you're an aspiring writer, aspiring YouTuber, aspiring podcaster, whatever the hell you want to be, aspiring doctor,
I don't know about aspiring doctor.
Well, you know, I mean, maybe the doctors are here. Yeah, they're watching this.
Yeah, they're like, no.
The brain surgeons are like, well, how do I be a brain surgeon?
Yeah,
tell me,
go,
Jason.
Yeah, just give me the scalpel and I'll go to work. And yeah, they're like, no, don't do that.
Just do it, brain surgeons. Just do it. You can buy cadavers on Craigslist. They're out there. Find them and just do it.
Just go to school and do it that way. That's the way to do it.
So I found, I didn't know this until I came to the other side of the fence in terms of like making comic books and writing TV pilots and stuff like that. We all want the magic key. And I call it the magic key because we all expect there to be some secret feather, some secret power-up, some secret mushroom. I don't know why it's all Mario, but it just is. that suddenly unlocks that part of your brain and shows you how to do it. Like we talked about the visual component. But the simple answer of it is that there is no magic key. There is no magic key. I can remember listening to podcasts like I would say maybe 10 years ago and being like, oh man, I want to be a writer. Okay, I'm going to listen to this podcast where this guy is a famous novelist and I'm going to listen to him. And he's on a panel, he's talking about his career. And I can remember finishing this podcast and the person never talked about how they got an agent. They never talked about that. And for some reason, I thought that that was the key.
Of course.
I was like, oh, once you get an agent you're set. Oh, you're Mr. Hollywood. But that's not it. Like, you can have, I have an agent. I'm not Mr. Famous. What makes the biggest difference is the work, is your video, your podcast, or your script. Whatever that is. That's what makes the difference. It's not any of this other crap, and there is no other magic key. So to me, I say just do it, because you're going to put so many blocks in your way. I certainly did it. I think we all do it. You're going to put so many things in your way to stop yourself. So stop it and just do it. Just make the thing, because even if you make a crappy thing,
you can always retool it, re-go down the line, do it better, and learn from it.
Or you're one step closer. You're just with one thing, you're different from what you were before. If you make one YouTube video, you're a YouTuber. If you write one thing, you're a writer. You're not an aspiring writer. That's why I always tell people, don't put aspiring filmmaker, don't put aspiring writer, aspiring artist on your Twitter profile or any social. No, you're an artist. You're a writer. You're a filmmaker. I don't care what level you are. If you are thinking about that's what you want to do, then you are it. Don't put aspiring says that you think you're not good enough. You are good enough. Just do it.
That's what it is. Just do it. I love it.
Yeah. I'm sorry, Nike.